Day two, the question we're supposed to answer was put the two lists together, one for steering parts, one for suspension parts. I've got those on the board over here. Steering parts would be steering gear, rack and pinion, tie rod, sensor link, fiber arm, adjustment sleeve, ball joint, and pitman arm. And on the other side is our suspension. We got leaf spring, coil spring, torsion bar, shock absorber, McPherson strut, sway bar, control arm, and ball joint. Okay. Day three, the question was about on alignment. What alignment specification does not affect tire wear? The answer was camber. The answer is not camber. The answer is caster. Camber is when the tire is tilted over on the side, so it's going to have one edge wear, either on the inside or the outside, depending on if it's negative or positive. Camber. Toe wind is going to cause feather edge wear. Caster, the only thing caster is going to affect is the ability for the steering wheel to return to center, and also will control a pull to one side or the other. If I have a lot of caster on one side and a little bit of caster on the other side, the car is going to pull to the side with the caster. So if you have a car that's pulling to one side or the other, first thing to check would be to make sure their tires are inflated equally. So if you have a side with a low tire, it's going to pull to the side with a low tire. But if the tires are inflated correctly, then you want to put on the alignment machine and check the caster. So today, the next question was, what alignment adjustment is done last? The last thing you do on alignment is set the toe. When you change caster and camber, it's going to affect the toe. So if you adjusted the toe first, then adjusted the camber, then the toe is going to be off. But toe does not affect caster and camber. So you set the caster and camber first, and then set the toe last. And the last question on day three was, what alignment adjustment causes tire shape? And I don't think a couple people got it right. The answer is, and I said right in the question there was a trick question. The answer is none. Alignment or wheel shape or tire shape is caused by out-of-balance tires, not anything to do with alignment. A lot of people will take their car to this shop because it's shaking. Say, I need an alignment. When in reality, they don't need an alignment. All they need is tire balance. Today, we're going to talk about the repair process of bringing your car into a shop and some of the things you will have to know if you work in a shop. First, let's talk about the process. The process, the customer brings the car in to a service rider. He tells the service rider what's wrong with his car. That is called a concern. So the first thing we write on the board is a concern. So we find out what the... We find out what the customer's concern is. For example, the customer says, hey, my radio doesn't work. Okay, customer's concerned, radio inoperative. Okay. The next thing, the service writer will give the repair order to a technician. He'll bring it back to the shop, and he'll verify the customer's concern. He'll turn on the radio, see if it's working. Okay, it's not working. So next thing he has to find is what is causing the radio not to work. Okay, so the next thing would be the cause. Let's say the technician checks around. First thing he checks is the fuse. He finds out the fuse is blown. So the next thing would be the correction. Okay, how do you fix a blown fuse? You replace it. And the last thing on the repair process is to verify the repair. So how do you verify the repair? You turn the radio on and see if it works. Let's say you turn that radio on and it works fine, so you drive the car out of the shop, and about halfway around the shop while you're parked at the customer's car, the radio quits working again. Oh, crap. So you pull it back in, you check it, and the fuse is blown again. What does that tell you? What makes the fuse blow? Well, you should know a fuse blows because the circuit is overloaded. Was the cause really the fuse? The cause was not the fuse. The cause was something else. Now we have to dig into a little deeper and find out what blew the fuse. So we pull the radio out, we check it, we find some wires that somebody had taped up, that the tape had come off, and the wires were touching some. short to ground. Well, we make a proper connection, we solder it, we put heat shrink tube on it, we tape it up so it can't short to ground. Then we put it back in the car, then we put another new fuse in it, and then we go road test it around and make sure it doesn't blow the fuse again, and it doesn't, and then we send the car down the road. So the concern was the radio doesn't work. The cause was a wire shorted to ground, which blew the fuse. The correction was repair the wire and replace the fuse, and then we drive around to verify the repair. Okay, you have to get those in order. If you get those out of order, you're going to be in trouble. All right, next thing we're going to talk about is some soft skills you need to have when you're working in a shop. First of all, mechanics don't get paid by the hour, they get paid by the job. So you could go to work all day and only do one job. Say you do some front brake pads. You're only going to get paid for doing front brake pads. You get paid about an hour. If it takes you 8 hours, you still only get paid 1 hour. So you have to have good time management skills. When I was working in the shop, if I was machining a brake rotor, you know, it takes about 10 minutes for that machine to cut that brake rotor. While that rotor was machining, I'd go over and do something else. I wouldn't stand there and watch it, because that's not productive. I'm not making any money. So you always want to stay busy. Go to the next job. Don't stand around and watch things happen. Another thing that with time management and staying on task is your phone. If I was working in the shop, I would not even bring my cell phone into the shop with me. I'd lock it up in my toolbox. I'd check it at break time. If I took a break, I never took a break. But maybe at lunchtime, I'd check it to see if I had any messages. We had a technician in the shop where I worked that he was always on his phone like this. He's working with wrenches with one hand, on his phone with the other hand. Okay, who's more productive, a one-arm technician or a two-arm technician? Two-arm technician's always going to make more money than a one-arm technician, because it's going to take him longer to do a job because he's always on his phone. So you're going to make a lot more money if you can just focus on working and not be on the phone. Punctuality. You have to be on time. I know at school, if you're not on time, they mark you tardy. Big deal. You get 5 tardies and you get a U. Big deal. At work, if you were tardy, if you were late coming into work 5 times and I was your boss, I would fire you. Okay. If you ever not showed up once, if you just missed one day without calling and telling me you weren't coming, you would not have a job the next day. So in the real world, you have to be punctual. You have to come to work every day, be on time. I used to show up a half hour early. I'd get that first job in. Slow day, there's not a lot of work. I get that first job in the door, and the other guys might have to stand around for a while before they got to work. Since they're not paid by the hour, I was making money, they weren't making money. That's about it, I think. Integrity. Don't try to sell something on their car they don't need. There's plenty of that going on. You don't need to do that. There's plenty of work to do on cars without selling something they don't need. If you say you did a job, you better well have done the job. Don't tell somebody you balanced their tires when you really just rotated them. It's going to come back and bite you in the butt. So do what you say you did. You might think you're making extra money by lying or cheating a customer out of some money, but in reality, you're going to lose that customer. If you have no customers, you make no money. All right, that's about it for today. I'm trying something new today. On your assignment, it says day 4. Click on it, and I think the assignment says answer the question below. Then you'll click on a Google document, and there'll be a question, and it's multiple choice, and just pick the right answer. If for some reason you can't get it to come up, message me or something. The question you want to answer